सदां बोधिवासं गलत्पुष्पहासं जगत्सन्निवासं शतादित्यभासं गदाचक्रशस्त्रं लसत्पीतवस्त्रं हसचारुवक्त्रं भजेहं भजेहं।
So there was one acharya in Madhva Sampradaya by name Vadiraja Tirtha, Vadiraja Tirtha. So when he was traveling around India, when he came to Pune, so at that time for a Chaturmasya he was staying at a temple in Pune. So there was local Vidvat Sabha. Vidvat Sabha means an assembly of people, all scholars. They have assembled to discuss which is a great scripture. So one Mayavadi scholar has written one book called Shishupala Vada, a book with Shishupala as the forecast. Everything from the perspective of Shishupala. So atheistic people, for them Rakshasas are the heroes. So when this book was almost to be selected, that this is the best book in poetry, so then Vadiraja Tirtha sent them a message that there is a competent book for this called Rukminisha Vijaya and it is in Udupi. Please give me 3 weeks time so that I'll procure the book, and you can also go through that book, and if you feel it is competent, then we will have a competition. So actually there is no such book written till that time. He took 3 weeks time to start writing that book. So in 19 days he wrote 19 episodes of the Lord, starting from his birth to the marriage of Rukmini Devi, of entire Bhagavatam in a poetic manner. He was contemplating on the Lord, and every day he was composing the verses. So after 19 days the book was complete. Then the book was presented to the assembly. They were all neutral people, nobody was favorable to them or here. So they all studied that book. When they studied that book, they became so fascinated by that book. They became so attracted by Krishna's pastimes and the explanation of the reasons why Krishna had performed those pastimes, that they selected this book is the best book they have ever come across in poetry. And as given a commitment, they made this book paraded on the elephant across the city, and they glorified Acharya for composing that. So after doing all these things and all, he won the assembly. So there, from there he went to Pandharipur. So he was staying in a temple there, Mata there. So every day having darshan of Lord Panduranga Vitala. So one day, one farmer came to his Mata and started scolding Acharya Vadiraja Tirtha, that your horse is coming every day to my field, corn field, and destroying the crop. Then Acharya said, we don't have any horse in this Mata, and I think you are mistaken. No, every day I see the horse, it comes, it eats the corn. When I about to chase, it will come to your Mata and it will vanish. So I want to search your entire Mata. He said, go, please search ahead. So after searching everywhere, he did not find the horse, but he said, no, I am sure that the horse belongs to you only, your Mata only. You should pay me back for the loss of my crop, whatever had happened. So in the meantime, Acharya could understand that this is the divine leela of the Lord. So he had asked him, where is your crop? Let me take me there. So went to the crop where the horse has eaten. And wherever the horse has eaten, there were golden corn everywhere. So that the person was amazed. Then he said, you are blessed. Lord Hayagriva has come and he has taken offering of your crops, and he has blessed you with this golden corn. Then immediately that person surrenders to Acharya, hands over that entire land to the Mata, and he becomes a devotee for the Lord. So like that, the special relationship with the Lord maintains. So the every day there is one special offering called Hayagrivam, offered to Lord Hayagriva. It is made of chana dal, coconut, some almonds and dry fruit. So he used to prepare the naivedya, and he used to hold with all the naivedya on his head, and he starts reciting Dashavatara Stuti in glorification of the Lord. So in that Dashavatara Stuti, in the meantime, when he was offering this naivedya to the Lord, Lord will come as a horse. He will place his two legs on his shoulders and he starts eating the naivedya offered from his head. And after eating almost 90%, he will eat 10% as prasadam for his devotee Acharya Vadiraja. So one day, there were some foolish people who did not believe, because everything was happening in a closed room. So foolish people were there who were thinking that this Acharya is faking. He is simply bluffing around. He is eating the entire food and he is saying Lord has eaten. So they thought, let us do one test. They mixed poison into the food then. So Acharya unknowingly offered the item to the Lord, and that day Lord finished everything without leaving anything.
Understanding there is some problem with the offering that day, Vadiraja goes into meditation. Lord explains to him that some people have mixed poison into that. If he had left that poison food, it will be affecting Vadiraja Tirtha. That's why Lord had consumed everything. To signify this event, the deity of Hayagriva becomes bluish in color. So Vadiraja, from then onwards, he will be offering one medicinal food which will cure the bluish color. At last, a small tinge remains on the neck of the deity to signify this event of testing the devotee with poison which Lord had consumed.
ദൈത്യകാലം നഭോ നീലകായം ദുരാവാരമായം സുപത്മസഹായം ഭജേഹം ഭജേഹം ഭജേഹം
രോമാകണ്ഠഹാരം ശ്രുതിവ്രാതസാരം ജലാന്തർവിഹാരം